A little something like this on the radio. Here we go.
Good people, so full of such bring the hottest cotton picking thing to cuts a red hot blue coming to WHBQ and Hotel Chiska on the magazine floor. Is that right, Dave? That's right. What do you call Sam Putney? Oh, I got to call Sam, Dave. Ah, Pete Picker. Hey, come on there, Earn. Good to see you, Earn. How you doing, buddy?
Very good, Putney. It's more like it. It's all right. It's okay. Nervous, new boy. Just go on out and get your wheelbarrow load of mat off, run them through the front door, and tell them Philip sent you for red.
I got a new song we're gonna play here. They're gonna cut loose this new song. I mean, a flat gig.
Well, that's all right, Mama. That's all right for you. That's all right, Mama. Just any way you do it, that's all right.
Hey.
That's all right.
Hey.
That's all right, Mama. Any way you do.
If Dewey didn't like your song, he would break it in the middle of it. But if he liked your song, he would try to sing along to it in the middle of it. So that's what those kind of moans and groans were there. So Dewey obviously loves it. The kids love it. They kind of just keep requesting it. So Dewey ends up playing it 14 times on his 2.5-hour radio show, which is, unheard of. So Sam, he knows this is huge. This never happens. So all he did was just the next day, he brought Elvis right next door into the cafe, and he signed him to a 3-year contract. It was signed. So happened that fast, right after the song was playing on the radio that first night. You know, think about it, you're 19 years old. One day you're a delivery truck driver, and the next day you're a signed recording artist. Your dreams are coming true. So Elvis comes back in here, starts to record songs for Sam the way that Sam likes. Songs are becoming huge around town and around the region. Elvis, Scotty, and Bill ended up putting out 5 records together on the Sun label, all double-sided, so 10 actual songs here on Sun. But that was in a span of only 17 months instead of the full 3 years, because the national labels are hearing about this kid in Memphis, Tennessee, and they're calling Sam up. They're making offers. And of course, Sam does not want to sell him, but he realizes these national labels can do Elvis a lot more justice than what he could do at this time, because he was still running a very small, tiny, independent label. He didn't have a lot of money for promotion. So Sam does end up selling Elvis's contract to RCA Victor for $35,000. But you have to remember, it's a lot of money back then. It was actually the most amount paid for a single recording artist at that time. So Sam called it his greatest business decision. He said, it was only me and Marion. Now I could start hiring employees, and now I really could start be promoting the other artists that were coming in here. So without that sale, we may have never heard of some people like Roy Orbison or Jerry Lee Lewis or Carl Perkins or Johnny Cash, Conway Twitty, Charlie Feathers, Charlie Rich, the list goes on. All those guys had their start here as well. So if you think about it, wasn't that bad of a trade-off, you know? At least for us. You guys are fans of them too, right? Maybe one or two of them?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to take an Elvis.